गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, दिस इज़ मिसेस अंजू मलीम, बायोलॉजी टीचर फॉर क्लास 10th फ्रॉम स्प्रिंगफील्ड स्कूल मासाबटैंग। चिल्ड्रन, इन माई लास्ट वीडियो आई हैव एक्सप्लेन टू यू अबाउट द मोनोहाइब्रिड क्रॉस एंड वी हैव सीन द लॉ ऑफ डोमिनेंस, द लॉ ऑफ सेग्रीगेशन, हाउ द जीन्स एंड द एलील्स सेग्रीगेट ड्यूरिंग द फर्टिलाइजेशन एंड how the new traits are formed. We have seen the various things: homozygous dominant, heterozygous dominant, homozygous recessive, genotypic and phenotypic ratios. Now today I am going to discuss with you what is dihybrid cross with an example. A dihybrid cross allows us to look at the pattern of inheritance of two different traits at the same time. In monohybrid cross, we have taken only tall and short, or we have taken yellow or green seeds. But in dihybrid, we will consider two traits at the same time. For example, say we are crossing two pea plants. The two traits we are looking at are the seed color and shape. The first seed is green and wrinkled, and the second is yellow and round. Now here, the yellow and round are actually dominant. Now let us see. A dihybrid cross describes a mating experiment between the two organisms that are identically hybrid for the two traits. From this his experiment, Mendel observed that the pairs of traits in the parental generation sorted independently from one another, from one generation to next. Now, to understand this, we have to see one cross. Cross means interpreting. Now what do you see in this slide? Parents. What are parents? Round and yellow. Round is capital 2 R's and yellow is 2 YR's. Round and yellow, wrinkled and green, they are recessive. Only when they are present in 2 small Y's and 2 small R's, they are wrinkled and green. Wherever the capital letters will come, they are the dominant genes, they will be expressed. Round will be expressed if capital R is there. Yellow will be expressed if capital Y is there. But when both the R's are small and both the Y's are small, then they are expressed as a wrinkled green. Now during the first cross, where we have taken the pea plants with two different pair of characters, round yellow and wrinkled green, and they are bred. In F1 generation, what do you observe? We observe that capital R, small r, capital Y, small y. That means both capitals are present, R and Y. That is why it is round and yellow. So in F1 generation, we get round and yellow. That is, round and yellow are dominant over wrinkled and green. They are heterozygous here. They are 100% round and yellow. Now, the next thing that we do is we separate the genes. So if we separate the genes, we are getting like this: round yellow, green yellow, round green, wrinkled green. I repeat, round yellow, capital R, capital Y. Sorry, wrinkled yellow, that is small r and capital Y. Capital R is again round and green. And last is wrinkled and green. So 4 genes you are getting at the top of the box and 4 genes you are getting at the side. One is male and other is female. So what? How many boxes will be formed? 4 into 4, 16 boxes will be formed. Now you make a cross. Side one with the top one. When you multiply, you get like that. So you are getting round yellow with different genetic composition. Wherever capital R is there or capital Y is there, it is going to be round yellow. So we have one round yellow. We have another type which is called as a wrinkled yellow. Wrinkled means 2 small R's should be there. Yellow with one capital Y also, it will be yellow, or with 2 capital Y's also. So I will read out from the first box: 2 capital R and capital Y, round and yellow. Next, capital R, small r, and 2 capital Y's, round and yellow again. again round and yellow because capital Y is there, again round and yellow because capital Y. So top line is finished. Second line, round and yellow because capital R and Y are present. Now the second box, second row is wrinkled and yellow because both are small r's. Then again round and yellow, again wrinkled and yellow with different genetic composition because two small r are there, they are wrinkled. Third line, first one, round and yellow because capital R is there. One or two doesn't matter. Whenever one capital R is also there, it is round, and one capital Y is also there, it is yellow. Round and yellow, round and yellow. Third line, round and green because two small Y's are there. You can see the orange one, round and green. Next is also round and green. Now the last line, the bottom line, round and yellow because two capitals are present, R and Y. Wrinkled and yellow. Do you see wrinkled? Why? Two small R's are there. So wrinkled is expressed when only it is in the homozygous form. That is, two should be there. One big R, one small R means no, it is round. It is not wrinkled. Wrinkled means two small R's. Round and green because two small Y's are there. So green will be expressed as two small Y's. Wrinkled and green. Now children, these are the different types of the seeds that we are getting. Pea plants with the seeds. Round yellow, wrinkled yellow, wrinkled and round green, and wrinkled green. Four types. So let us count them. If you see the yellow boxes, they are 9. Count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So round yellow are 9. Wrinkled yellow are 3. Round green are 3. And wrinkled green is 1. So we say that the phenotypic ratio is 9:3:3:1. We cannot write genotypic. It will become a very long ratio. 1:2:2:2:1:2:2:1 like that. So we will only learn in dihybrid cross the phenotypic ratio is 9:3:3:1. Remember. Here it is a. Again the same chart is there just to show you the ratios. Can you see in the corner? 9 out of 16, 3 out of 16, 3 out of 16, 1 out of 16. So 9:3:3:1. This is the phenotypic ratio of the dihybrid cross. Genotypic ratio you need not learn. Okay children? Okay. So from this experiment, Mendel concluded the law of the independent assortment. That is, Mendel's law of independent assortment states that the alleles of two or more different genes get sorted into gametes independently of one another. In other words, the allele a gamete receives for one gene does not influence the allele received for the another gene. See, if it is yellow, if it is round, it need not be yellow only. It can be round and green also. If it is wrinkled, it should not be always wrinkled with green. It can be wrinkled with yellow also. So the genes are independently assorted, separated out, and the cross takes place. So the very good example of the dihybrid cross is this, what we have considered, round, yellow with green and wrinkled. So these are the two examples we have seen, monohybrid cross and also the dihybrid cross. Now coming to the another important aspect of sex determination in human beings. Normally you must have observed in villages, people start cursing women if she gives birth to baby girls. But let me tell you, mothers are not responsible for the sex of the baby. Whether the boy is born or a girl is born, it is not the mother who is responsible for that. It is only the father who is responsible for the sex of the baby. That is, the boy is born or the girl is born. Whoever is born, that responsibility will be the father's. It is because of father, the baby is boy or a girl. Let us study how. Now you all know that our body is made up of cells, And cells have nucleus, nucleus have chromosomes, and they are, chromosomes are of two types, allosomes and autosomes. Actually, we have 23 pairs of chromosomes, that is 46 chromosomes. 23 pairs means 46 chromosomes, out of which 22 are the autosomes. 22 means 44. 22 pairs means 44 chromosomes are autosomes. One pair is sex chromosome. For females, the sex chromosome will be XX. And for males, the sex chromosome will be XY. This Y is actually responsible for the male character. Let us see. In females, the pair of sex chromosomes have both X chromosomes, that is XX pair, whereas in males, the pair of sex chromosomes have X and Y chromosomes, XY. In males as well as females, the gamete, sperm or ova contains 23 pairs, that is 46 chromosomes, out of which 22 are autosomes and one is sex chromosome. Now let us see, observe this one. Father is XY, mother is XX. Now for the children to be born, suppose what is the probability of giving birth to a boy or a girl? One haploid cell will come from the father and one from the mother, making it a diploid zygote. So if X come from father, because mother has only one type of cells, X, so it is father. If his sperm carrying the X chromosome fertilizes with the ova of the mother, then the born child will be daughter. If the Y sperm of the father fertilizes with the ova of the mother, then the boy is born. That is, we have the chances of 50-50, 50% chances of producing boy and 50% chances of producing girl. Now let us see one more chart here. You can observe in this chart, 46 chromosomes are there. Yes, 23 pairs and 46 chromosomes. 23 pairs and 46 chromosomes. Out of which 22 chromosomes are different. Maybe one is for eye color, maybe height, maybe skin color, like that. Hair color. But only one pair of chromosome is responsible for the sex, whether it's a male or female, like this. Female is XX, 44 chromosomes, and XX, together 46. 44 chromosomes in male and one XY, together 46, that is 23 pairs. So we have 23 pairs, or you can call it as 46 chromosomes. 22 pairs or 44 chromosomes are autosomes, and one pair, or you can call two chromosomes, are sex chromosome. In females, XX, and in male, XY. It is the Y which determines the sex of the baby. So determining the sex in humans, you have to understand that the humans have the 23 pairs of chromosomes. And the sex of the child will be determined by the type of the chromosome inherited from the father. A child who inherits Y chromosomes will be a boy, and a child who inherits X chromosome will be a girl. That means the mother is having two X ovas, but all are of the similar types of ovas. She cannot produce two types of ovas, but father can produce two types of sperms, X and Y. So it is depending upon the type of the sperm, X or Y, which fertilizes with the ova. If X fertilizes with the ova, then girl will be born, and if Y fertilizes with the ova, then male, boy, will be born. This is there in your textbook, please go through. See children, when you are asked in the exam, you just cannot draw the flowcharts of dihybrid cross, monohybrid cross and this sex determination human beings. You have to write the points. I have not given in the video the points, they are there in the PDF question answers. So whenever this question is asked, explain the dihybrid cross, you must write down the points which I have given in the PDF. And if the question is asked, how is the sex determined in human beings, you have to write the points that I have given in the PDF. here again explaining the same thing. What is the probability of giving birth to a female child or a male child? It is 50-50%. But remember, it's not the mother who is responsible for giving birth to a male child or a female child. It's a father who is responsible for the sex of the baby. Whether the baby is boy or a girl, it is because it is the responsibility of father. So what do we conclude? Human beings have XX and XY as a sex determination system. In this, the males have XY sex chromosomes. They produce two types of gametes, X and Y, two types of sperms. Determining the sex, humans have 23 pairs of chromosomes. Thus, the sex of the child will be determined by the chromosome inherited from their father. A child who inherits Y chromosome will be a boy, because X will come from girl, mother. X will come from mother, Y will come from father. So the resulting will be XY. So it will be a boy. And if the X sperm of the father fertilizes with the ova of the mother, then it will be double X. So it will be a girl. It is finally father who decides the sex of the baby. We have learned today the hybrid cross with an example, law of independent assortment and the sex determination in human beings. Homework for today, explain dihybrid cross with an example, draw the checkerboard, write all the points which are there in the PDF, please go through. Second question, how sex determination takes place in human beings, explain with an example. All these questions are important. What I gave you in my last video, what is monohybrid cross, explain. What is dihybrid cross, explain. How is the sex determination taking place in human beings? All these three are very important, kindly learn them properly. Hope you understood the concept. Thank you very much for watching this video.